Hi everyone, it's Emmett from Pi My Life Up. In this video, we'll be showing you how to install the Steam Link software on a Raspberry Pi. Steam Link is a software that allows you to easily stream your games from a more powerful computer. Thanks to Steam Link having built-in support for the Steam streaming protocol, you don't actually have to set up anything extra to be able to link your Raspberry Pi to your more powerful computer. To get the best experience of streaming your games to your Raspberry Pi, we highly recommend that you use an Ethernet connection. This will help maintain a lower latency and improve the response times of the games that you are playing. Additionally, for the best experience, you will also want to be using a Raspberry Pi 5. However, the Steam Link software does support any device newer than the Raspberry Pi 3. On top of this, you will likely want to connect a controller. The Steam Link software has support for most controllers that you might use, such as the Xbox controllers, the Sony DualShock 4, as well as the Nintendo Switch Pro controller. You can even use a keyboard and mouse if you wanted. Now, before you get started, you'll want to be running the desktop version of Raspberry Pi OS. For this particular guide, we'll be using the 64-bit release of Raspberry Pi OS Bookworm Desktop. Once you are ready to proceed, open up the terminal on your Raspberry Pi. The first thing we'll want to do is update any out-of-date packages on our Raspberry Pi's operating system. Before we can do this, we must first update the package list cache by typing in sudo apt update and pressing enter. Once the package list is updated, you can upgrade any out-of-date packages by typing in sudo apt upgrade hyphen y and then pressing enter. With that done, all we need to do to install Steam Link to our Raspberry Pi is to type in sudo apt install Steam Link hyphen y. The latest version of the Steam Link software is offered directly through the official Raspberry Pi OS repository. Once the installation is completed, we can move on to connecting your Raspberry Pi to Steam. To launch the Steam Link software, all you need to do is type in Steam Link and then press enter. The first time that you run this software, it will automatically update itself as well as install some additional software to your Raspberry Pi, as well as set up some rules so that it can access your connected controllers. Once it has copied the UDEV rules into place, you'll need to press enter to continue launching the Steam Link software on your Raspberry Pi. Once the software is started, you'll need to select the Get Started button to begin linking your Raspberry Pi to Steam using the Steam Link software. The Steam Link software will now scan for any computers that has Steam running on it. If your computer does not appear, you'll need to ensure that you have the remote play functionality turned on. Here you can see that it successfully detected my computer as well as another one that's on the same network. If you had to readjust the settings for your client, you'll want to click the rescan button. Otherwise, select the computer that you want to link to your Raspberry Pi. Once selected, the Steam Link software will automatically begin attempting to connect your Raspberry Pi to the Steam client. You'll then be shown a pairing code that you must enter within the Steam client running on your PC. Changing over to our PC, you can see that it already popped up with a prompt asking us to enter the pairing code. Type in the pairing code being displayed by your Raspberry Pi, and then press the confirm button. Once paired, the Steam Link software on your Raspberry Pi will automatically test the connection to the Steam client. This will help it test and verify the settings it needs to use to maintain a good connection. Once the test has been completed, all you need to do is click the OK button to continue. The Steam Link software on your Raspberry Pi will automatically optimize itself for low bandwidth situations. At this point, you can begin streaming your games to your Raspberry Pi by pressing the Start Playing button. However, we're going to take this one step further and get the Steam Link software to start when our Raspberry Pi does. This will save us the hassle of having to manually run the Steam Link software every time we want to stream a game to our Raspberry Pi. This is especially useful if you are dedicating this Pi to just game streaming. You can quit out back to the desktop by pressing the Escape key on your keyboard. Back in the terminal, we'll want to edit the auto start file for our desktop. You can edit this file by typing in sudo nano /etc/xdg/labwc/autostart. This file is automatically read in when the Raspberry Pi's compositor, which is now labwc, is started. To the bottom of this file, you'll want to add Steam link. You could take this a step further by commenting out the four lines above it by adding a hashtag to each one. This will stop the normal desktop interface from loading. However, we'll be sticking to just launching the Steam Link software at boot. Once done, save and quit by pressing Ctrl plus X and then Y and then Enter. Let's verify that this change worked by restarting our Raspberry Pi. You can reboot your Raspberry Pi by typing in sudo space reboot and then pressing Enter. When your Raspberry Pi restarts, you'll see the desktop interface briefly appear before the Steam Link software launches. At this point, all we need to do to start streaming games to our Raspberry Pi using Steam Link is to press the Start Playing button. To give you an idea of how this all works, we'll be using an Xbox controller with our Raspberry Pi, and then we're going to stream the game called Dynasty Warriors Origins. Once your Raspberry Pi begins streaming, you'll find you'll have access to the Steam Big Picture mode. This is incredibly useful as it works really nicely with controllers. Here we can see the Dynasty Warriors Origins game, and then we're going to launch it. Depending on the game you're playing, you'll be given additional information that can help improve the experience of using a controller to play it. Now let's skip ahead a bit so you can just see how a game looks like when it's been streamed to a Raspberry Pi. With this gameplay, you can easily see how well the Steam Link software can stream games to your Raspberry Pi. The latency is barely noticeable, especially in games where precise inputs aren't necessarily required. Visually, the stream looks very decent. There's no real noticeable loss of any frames, and there's very little additional artifacting being introduced, which is probably something that's a bit hard to see in the YouTube video because of the compression that the YouTube platform applies when you upload a video. Now, depending on the controller that you're using with your Raspberry Pi and playing games with, the method you'll use to stop the stream differs slightly. In our case, with an Xbox controller, we can press the Xbox button to bring up the Steam interface. We'll then go down and select the power option and then select the stop streaming to Raspberry Pi option. You'll then be returned back to the Steam Link interface. Hopefully at this point you have also managed to get the Steam Link software up and running on a Raspberry Pi. It truly is one of the easiest and best methods for streaming video games to the Raspberry Pi, especially since it requires very little configuration. While software like Moonlight might produce a better image, it does require a fair bit of extra tinkering. If you liked this guide, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.